After studying this module, we shall be able to know the various types of operating and financial budgets, elaborate sales budget, production budgets, explain production cost budget and ending inventory budget, understand cost of goods sold budget and selling expenses budget, and learn administrative expenses budget and budgeted income statement budget.
The budgeting process culminates in the preparation of budgets. There are several kinds of budgets. We can classify them on the basis of A. Coverage, B. Capacity, C. Periods. A. On the basis of coverage, master budgets, operational budgets, sales budget, production cost budget, ending inventory budget, selling expenses budget, cost or goods sold budget, administrative expenses budget, financial budgets, capital expenditure budget, research and development budget, cash budget, budgeted statement of changes in financial position. B. On the basis of efficiency, flexible budget and fixed budget. C. On the basis of period, long period budget, short period budget. A master budget is an overall comprehensive budget of the entire organization, which incorporates the various operating and financial budgets of the business. Operating budgets are concerned with the physical activities and operations of a business, such as sales, production, purchasing, and so on. Financial budgets are concerned with the financial aspects of a business, such as expected cash receipts, disbursements, financial position, financial results of operations of a firm, and so on. In this module, we are going to discuss the various types of operating and financial budgets.
The budgets related to the physical activities or operations of a business are called operating budgets. The various operating budgets are sales budget, production cost budget, ending inventory budget, cost of goods sold budget, selling expenses budget, administrative expenses budget, and budgeted income statement budget. The sales estimate is the foundation for other operating budgets, so the budgeting process begins with the determination of sales budget.
The sales budget is forecast of total sales to be achieved in a budget period expressed in monetary or quantitative terms. It is prepared by sales manager. This budget acts as a foundation for all other functional budgets like production budget, cash budget, cost of goods sold budget, etc., which depend on budgeted sales volume. It is the most challenging budget because estimating future sales is difficult due to continuous changes in the conditions of the economy and the company itself. Therefore, both internal and external factors are taken into account before making a sales forecast.
The important factors that should be considered while making sales forecasts are 1. Past trend in sales. This is the most authentic and easily accessible source of information which companies use in predicting future sales. Analyzing past sales product-wise, area-wise, and customer-wise can prove very useful in devising appropriate marketing and pricing policies. 2. Estimates by sales force. Since salesmen are in direct contact with the customers, and know their behavior better, they are in a position to estimate the potential demand more accurately. Number 3. Company-specific factors. The plant capacity, the availability of raw materials and supplies, the size of workforce and procurement of labor with required skills, the arrangement of finance are some of the critical factors to be considered in making projections about sales. Number 4. Changes in firm's price policies. The firm should assess its pricing policies to see how customer demand would react to the change in the prices of its commodities. Generally, sales can be increased by reducing the prices and vice versa. Number 5. Changes in the product mix. The firm should also study the effect of changes in the product mix on the sales level as well as contribution margin. Then, efforts should be made to increase the sales of the most promising product. Number 6. Marketing research. Surveys and marketing research should be conducted to collect information about customer taste, preference, purchasing patterns, disposable incomes, etc. Such information leads to better product mix decisions and sales forecast. Number 7. Advertising and sales promotion plans. The impact of advertising campaign and sales promotion techniques should be assessed and incorporated in the sales forecast. If the company is proposing to undertake some major expansion or discontinuation plan, it will affect the sales volume. Number 8. Competitors' actions. The strategies and actions of the competitor, such as changes in their prices, product quality, promotion policies, or new features in their products, can greatly affect the sales of the organization and therefore must be considered. Number 9. General economic conditions. The sales forecast should be made in the light of general economic conditions prevailing in the economy, like composition and purchasing power of population, growth in the national income and disposable income, seasonal and cyclical factors, international developments like petroleum prices and gold prices, labor market conditions, presence of substitutes, etc. Last and number 10. Government policies. The government policies on exports, imports, taxes, interest, inflation, FDI, foreign exchanges, etc. have bearing on the operations of the business and should also be analyzed before making sales forecast. The forecasters should take note of government published predictions, forecasts for many economic indicators such as GDP, national income, production indexes, inflation, etc. while making sales forecasts. Having made sales forecast in the light of important factors, the sales budget is prepared according to products, territories, customers, and period in the manner described as number 1. Product-wise sales budget, which is in case a company manufactures several products or variation of products, sales budget is prepared product-wise. This will apprise management about the popularity of its various products. Number 2. Territory-wise sales budget, which means when a company sells its products in different geographical territories, then sales budget should be prepared for each territory. This will help management in fixing separate sales targets for each territory, distribution of costs among them, devising incentive schemes based on their performances, etc. Customer-wise sales budget. If a company sells its products to different customers, such as wholesalers, retailers, public, government agencies, foreign businesses, and the like, then it should prepare the budget customer-wise. This will help in revealing the contribution of each type of customer to the total sales of the business firm and help in drawing proper marketing policies. Period-wise sales budget. The sales budget in terms of quantity and value should be broken down further into quarterly sales figure or monthly sales figures. This would ensure coordination between production, purchasing, and sales department and would also help in fixing quotas for salesmen. The specimen of a sales budget is shown here. Production budget. A production budget is a plan that shows the quantity of units of each product to be manufactured to cater to the sales forecast and to keep the desired levels of inventories. It is prepared by the production manager. It is generally expressed in physical units. The production budget is based on sales budget, but in those cases where sales cannot be precisely forecasted due to frequent changes in fashion and style, it is based on past experience. Units to be produced are equal to budgeted sales plus desired level of closing inventory of finished goods minus opening inventory of finished goods. The objectives of production budget are to plan what to produce, how much to produce, when to produce, and where to produce. To lay down the production program that helps in maintaining optimum balance between sales, inventories, and production at the minimal cost. To serve as the foundation for the preparation of production cost budget, cash budget, material requirement budget, direct labor budget, and factory cost budget. To maintain the desired level of inventory so that there is neither shortage of goods during the peak season nor surplus stock during the slack season. To make optimum utilization of plant capacity. To make proper arrangements for material, labor, power, etc. so that production can take place smoothly. Lastly, to highlight the weaknesses and source of potential trouble which could be averted by taking timely actions. In the production budget, the annual budget figures could be further broken down into monthly or quarterly estimates. The key factors such as factors which can limit the volume of production should be identified. Measures should be taken to insulate the production from adverse effects of key factors. The preventive measures when plant capacity, the key factors should be number 1, adoption of latest modern techniques, 2, timely repair and maintenance, 3, improving the plant layout, 4, multiple shifts, night shifts, and when raw material is the key factor, the measures that should be taken are number 1, scouting for alternative raw materials, 2, redesigning the product, 3, product modification, and lastly, to reduce intake of scarce raw material. Factors to be considered while preparing production budget are inventory policy of the firm. The inventory standard should be laid down so that there is neither surplus nor shortage of goods. Sales requirements. The quantity of goods to be produced depends largely on the quantity of goods to be sold. Hence, preparation of sales budget precedes production budget. Production stability. In order to have stability in employment, better use of plant facility and reduction of costs, the production should be evenly spread throughout the budget period. Key factors. Key factors should be identified and proper preventive measures should be taken to minimize their adverse impact. Time taken in production process. The production should commence depending upon the time it takes the factory to translate raw material into finished goods. Production cost budget. Production budget is the key to production cost budget. After determining the volume of production, it is desired to determine the cost of producing this output. Just as cost of production comprises of material, labor, and overheads, similarly, production cost budget comprises of materials cost budget, direct labor cost budget, and factory overhead budget. Material budget. A material budget specifies the expected quantities of each raw material required for the budgeted production. Materials used in the production process could be direct or indirect. The material budget includes only direct material, and indirect materials are considered in the factory overhead budget. The material budget can be divided into two parts. Number one, material usage budget, which tells us the total raw material required to be used in production process in terms of quantity or value. Number two, material purchase budget, which tells us the raw material required to be purchased for producing the required output in terms of quantity or value. The material budget could be expressed in physical terms, but when prices of materials are also considered, then we can ascertain the cost also. The material budget helps purchasing department to prepare purchase schedule to enable uninterrupted delivery of materials for production. It helps finance managers to determine finances required to meet the production targets. Factors to be considered while preparing materials budget are as follows. Production budget. The budgeted production will determine how much materials will be required for producing required output. Prices of raw material. To determine the cost of raw material, quantity of raw material is multiplied by its price. Standard usage. In case raw material requirements can be standardized, the budget can be prepared precisely. Standard usage refers to input minus output ratio. For example, how many units of material is used in producing one unit of output. If it is not possible to work out standardized raw material requirements, then percentage of raw material to total cost of product should be calculated on the basis of historical data, and this ratio can be used as a basis for ascertaining material cost. Normal loss / wastage in the production process. The material budget should also consider what percentage of raw material normally gets wasted in the production process. Efforts should be taken to keep normal loss to minimum. Inventory policy. The reorder level. Economic order quantity. The desired level of minimum stock and maximum inventory. Operating inventory. Closing inventory. All have bearing on material cost budget. Direct labor budget. The budget gives the estimates of direct labor requirements essential for carrying out the budgeted output. This budget is devised to ensure that the required number of employees of relevant grades and suitable skills are available at the right time. This budget considers only the direct labor, while the indirect labor is included in the factory overhead budget. Direct labor budget may be expressed in physical terms or physical hours, but when wage rates are also available, then we can ascertain the cost also. The direct labor budget may be divided into two parts. Number one, direct labor requirement budget, which specifies the total direct labor required for carrying the estimated production in terms of quantity or value. Two, direct labor procurement budget, which specifies the additional workers required to be recruited for carrying out the required production. Direct labor budget enables the personnel department to recruit the required number of workers of suitable skills and provide them necessary training. It is also used for preparing the cost of sales budget and cash budget. Factors to be considered while preparing labor budgets are: number one, production budget. The budgeted production will determine how much of labor hours are required. Number two, wage rate. To determine the cost of labor, the labor hours are multiplied by the average wage rate per labor hour. The overtime wage rate should be considered if workers work more than normal hours. Number three, standard labor usage. When labor usage can be standardized, the budget can be prepared precisely. Standard usage refers to input-output ratio. For example, how many labor hours are required to produce one unit of output. If it is not possible to standardize labor requirements, then percentage of labor cost to total cost of production should be calculated on the basis of historical data, and this ratio can be used as a basis for ascertaining labor cost. The formula being labor cost is equal to labor cost per unit into number of budgeted production. Labor cost per unit is equal to number of labor hours required per unit of output multiplied by wage rate per labor hour. Factory overhead budget. The budget sets out the estimated cost of indirect material, indirect labor, and indirect factory expenses during the budget period. There are a number of steps which are required to be taken into account while preparing factory overhead budget. These are: number one, classification of overheads into fixed, variable, and semi-variable expenses. Two, departmentalization of expenses. And number three, determining the level of activity. Classification of overheads into fixed, variable, and semi-variable expenses. Fixed overheads are those which remain constant irrespective of level of activity, such as property tax, supervisor's salary, depreciation, etc. Variable overheads are those which vary with the level of activity, such as supplies, repairs, etc. Semi-variable overheads are those which are partly variable and partly fixed. Fixed overheads can be estimated with a fair degree of accuracy on the basis of past experience. Variable overheads are estimated on the basis of scheduled production and operating conditions in the budget period. Departmentalization of expenses. The expenses should be classified department-wise. This would help in determining how much expenses are incurred by various departments, and the departmental heads can be held accountable. Determining the level of activity. The level of activity will be determined on the basis of production schedule. Once the level of activity is determined, per unit overhead rate will be computed and applied on goods to find their cost of production.
Ending inventory budget. Ending inventory budget shows the quantity as well as the value of closing inventory of the direct materials as well as finished goods of the company. These figures are used in preparation of budgeted balance sheet of the organization. If varieties of direct materials are used, then category wise breakup should be shown. Similarly, if numbers of products are manufactured, then product wise breakup should be shown. The quantities must be multiplied by the applicable rate to determine the cost of materials in the inventory and cost of finished goods in the inventory.
The specimen of ending inventory budget is shown here. Cost of goods sold budget shows the budgeted manufacturing cost, which is direct material, direct labor, and factory overheads. This is adjusted for beginning and ending inventory of finished goods. This budget can be prepared only after material cost budget, labor cost budget, factory overhead budget, and ending inventory budget have been prepared. This budget uses the estimates produced by the above said budgets to determine the budgeted cost of goods sold. Specimen of cost of goods sold budget is shown here.
Selling expenses budget includes all expenses relating to selling, advertising, distribution, and delivery of goods to the customers. Selling expenses include salesman's salaries, sales office establishment expenses, traveling expenses, commissions, etc. Advertising expenses include expenses relating to publicity, samples, advertisement expenses in journals, press, radio, and television, etc. Distribution expenses include transportation, freight charges, packaging charges, warehousing charges, insurance, etc. This budget is based on sales budget and is prepared on the basis of past experience. Advertising policies, research programs, market analysis, etc. It is generally prepared territory wise by the sales manager of each territory. The costs are segregated into fixed and variable costs.
Specimen of selling expenses budget is shown here.
Administrative expenses budget. This budget covers the expenditure related to management, legal, financial, accounting, and administrative activities of the organization. Formulation of this type of budget poses problems as engineering costs, purchasing costs can be classified under both production as well as administrative costs. Therefore, difficulty arises in deciding their correct classification. Also, it is not easy to identify the persons responsible for the incurrence and control of these costs. Administrative expenses could be director's remuneration, legal charges, audit fee, office expenses, rent, interest, taxes, postage, etc. Generally, these expenses are fixed and are shown in the budget under different categories.
Specimen of administrative expenses budget is shown here. Budgeted income statement budget. A budgeted income statement is prepared by using estimates provided by individuals operating budgets such as sales budget, cost of goods sold budget, selling expenses budget, and administrative expenses budget. This budget shows the expected income that would be generated in the organization in the budgeted period. If tax rates are known, income before and after taxes can also be ascertained. Specimen of budgeted income statement budget is shown here.
Let us now summarize what we have discussed in this module. The number and types of budgets to be prepared by a business depends on the size and nature of the business. There are several kinds of budgets which can be classified on the basis of coverage, capacity, or periods. On the basis of coverage, budgets could be operating budgets, financial budgets, or master budget. On the basis of efficiency, budgets could be fixed or flexible. Operating budgets relate to physical activities and operations of the business. Financial budgets are related to financial aspects of the business. A master budget combines and integrates the various operational and financial budgets. Sales budget acts as a foundation for all other budgets. It is most challenging budget and prepared first of all. It gives forecast of total sales to be achieved in a budget period. Sales budgets could be production-wise sales budgets, territory-wise sales budgets, customer-wise sales budgets, period-wise sales budgets, etc. Production budget shows quantity of each product to be manufactured in a budget period to meet sales forecast and maintain desired level of inventory. Production cost budget shows the cost of production of required output in a budget period. It comprises of material budget, labor budget, factory overheads budget. Ending inventory budget shows quantity and value of closing inventory of direct materials and finished goods. Cost of goods sold budgets show budgeted manufacturing costs adjusted for opening and closing stocks of finished goods. Selling expenses budget shows all expenses relating to selling, advertising, distribution, and delivery of goods to customers. Administrative expenses budget shows all expenditure related to administration, legal, audit, financial and accounting activities of a business in a budget period. Budgeted income statement shows income expected to be generated in a budget period and is prepared using estimates provided by various operating budgets.